Science certainly affects everything we do, but it's also true that we affect the scientific process. Imagine that science and society communicate through a game of telephone. Information is passed from hand to hand, or institution to institution. You see, scientists publish research papers, which eventually reach policymakers, who then apply the knowledge in ways that benefit the world. Right? Well, sort of. This picture gets complicated once you realize that society creates a climate of social, economic, and political factors that influence scientists and policymakers. The linear game of telephone becomes a loop, and the scientific message is more likely to become distorted. Here, we can show you how this loop is formed by telling the story of asbestos mining in South Africa. Wait. You've probably heard of asbestos, but do you really know what it is? Asbestos is a mineral that's stronger than steel, inflammable, sound absorbent, and flexible, which makes it an economically important resource. Between 1910 and 2002, South Africa was the world's third largest exporter of asbestos. During that time, South Africa turned a huge profit, mining more than 10 million tons of it. That's equivalent to almost 28 Empire State Buildings. But let's take a closer look at the social context. In 20th century South Africa, life was divided along racial lines of apartheid. The government enforced segregation of public spaces, medical care, even citizenship. With limited employment opportunities, many black South Africans turned to manual work, like asbestos mining. Entire families would work together to drill, collect, and separate asbestos from the earth. But asbestos, as it turns out, is particularly dangerous to mine. Although asbestos may look like solid rock, when it's drilled and blasted by miners, it can unravel into millions of small fibers which people can breathe in. Normally, when a foreign substance enters the lungs, it gets digested into mucus and coughed up. But asbestos dust builds up over time, eventually causing inflammation and the formation of scar tissue. Daily exposure to asbestos may cause serious respiratory problems that appear later in life. Illnesses can lay dormant for decades within the body, such as mesothelioma, which are cancerous tumors that form in vital organs. Families of mine workers knew they were getting sick from asbestos exposure, but the industry ignored their protests. As more people found out about the dangers of asbestos, how long do you think it took for mines to start implementing workplace safety regulations? In 1959, scientists presented extensive research demonstrating that mesothelioma was unusually common in South African miners, and that even brief exposure to asbestos could cause symptoms to appear. It wasn't until 1986 that mining companies started negotiating with miners to improve workplace safety. It took over a quarter of a century for this science to be implemented into policy. What happened here to cause such a delay between science and action? Well, remember how society shapes the game of telephone into a loop? Between 1959 and 1986, South Africa's economic interests favored asbestos mining, further distorting the scientific message. The 1959 publication prompted the mining industry to fund research on the health effects of asbestos, but this research wasn't at all designed to examine the link between workplace conditions and lung disease. For example, one study even attempted to link mesothelioma to a polio vaccine that most South Africans hadn't even received. Meanwhile, the mines continued business as usual, while black laborers protested their unsafe working conditions. In the mid-70s and early 80s, the asbestos trade slowed as both global and domestic economic pressure against apartheid increased. In 1986, after a national anti-asbestos campaign and several more strikes, the first health and safety requirements for the asbestos mining industry were finally put into place. In the end, it took a perfect storm of social, political, and economic factors for science done in the lab to directly benefit workers in the mine. Today, scientific discoveries are made at an accelerated rate. All of the new information goes through a similar game of telephone. The story of asbestos mining shows us that while society depends on informed science, scientists also need reminding of social contexts. A study in 2008, for example, showed that carbon nanotubes have a fiber shape similar to asbestos. When mice were exposed to these nanotubes, they developed mesothelioma-like symptoms. Billions of dollars are funding nanotechnology research, and carbon nanotubes can already be found in a variety of products, from sunscreen to eyeglasses. In short, scientists have introduced a promising material, but ongoing research points to potentially harmful effects of its use. Sound familiar? Science is a series of social interactions, and especially when it comes to health, any conflicting messages in the conversation can have serious consequences. People such as science writers, professors, and citizen scientists work against the likelihood of these miscommunications. Moving forward, it is important to shorten the gap between scientists and the public to fortify the imperfect loop and keep scientific messages connected to their social contexts.